Today we will talk about very important topic, about airdrop. Or rather about retrodrop that everyone is madly waiting for. This is Retrodrop MetaMask. In this video we will figure out how to increase the chance of getting token from MetaMask wallet, what we need to do and go through the step-by-step instructions. I will show what I did. And in the end, we hope that this action will lead to a good reward. Put like and subscribe to the channel. And please write the comment, did you manage to do all the steps? Or at what stage did you have questions? If something does not work out, please write it in the comment. I will try to answer on all your questions.
Today in this video we will do three groups of actions. The first is to use the swap inside the MetaMask. Second, we will use the MetaMask portfolio, which was realized not so long ago. And the third, completely new things that we can test in the MetaMask bridge. Most recently, MetaMask launched a bridge aggregator that runs on the Ethereum, Polygon, Avalanche and Binance chain networks. And as I said a year ago, the MetaMask plans to launch a token, although this was not announced anywhere. Now, there is already a statement that MetaMask will issue the mask token and that the DAO will be created. Therefore, it will not be superfluous to do all the actions, even in several accounts with several MetaMask wallets in order to increase the chance. Go to the MetaMask portfolio. Here we can see all the accounts and all the networks of our wallet. Above, we display the Ethereum network, then the BNB network. Below, we have the USDT network on the Avalanche network. I have $51 here, BUSD, Matic in Polygon, Optimist network, $12 on it, Ethereum in the Arbitrum network for $3.86. Below Ethereum in the Optimist network, then Avalanche and a few more tokens. In order to increase the chance of a retrodrop, we can use the bridge that we have below the portfolio. I immediately warn you that there are large commissions here if you make a transfer from the Ethereum network. That is, you should be prepared for the fact that you will have to spend about $30-$50 to spend crypto assets from one network to another through the bridge. Therefore, if you are not ready for the cost, then it is better not use bridge inside. Once again, this can only increase the chance of a retrodrop, since a retrodrop is such a reward that no one is guaranteeing. That is, no one promises that if you use the bridge or do swaps inside MetaMask, then we'll be given token for this. But nevertheless, it can turn out to be a very pleasant surprise in the end. The first example that I will take to exchange is from the Avalanche network to the Polygon network. Select the tokens that we want to change. I choose USDT. I have $50 here. I press the maximum button and I press approve the token below. First, you need to confirm approve in MetaMask, which we will do now. Wait a while and then click on submit transaction. That is, confirm the transaction itself. That's it. Our transaction has flow away. Bridging in process is writing. This transaction took 14 minutes, after which we go to MetaMask and check that our USDT has finally been transferred to the Polygon network. In the next step, I will now transfer this USDT from the Polygon network to the Binance Smart Chain network. We choose Polygon, BNB Smart Chain. I choose USDT, I press maximum, and accordingly below, be sure to pay attention to the commission. Here the commission is simply negligible. So we do approve and wait for a while. By the way, in the right corner, you can see choose a different quote. You can choose either a regular transaction or an accelerated one. Therefore, if you want to send faster, you can choose fastest. After the approval has been completed, we confirm the transaction itself also with the MetaMask wallet. And we have a window that displays the process of transferring the crypto assets of the Polygon network, in our case, to the Binance Smart Chain network. Our transaction was completed in 9 minutes. And then we sent our USDT from the Binance Smart Chain network to the Ethereum network. You can choose any other crypto assets or another stablecoins, USDT or DAI, it doesn't matter. Since I had USDT, I just run them through all the bridges. Please note that sending to Ethereum with Binance Smart Chain is expensive, as my 50 USDT turns into 30 USDT. Therefore, I lose $20 for the transaction. click Approve Confirm with your wallet. We see that approve has been completed and then we confirm the transaction itself. Everything in the transaction flew away. We are waiting for the bridge to be transferred to the Ethereum network. There is also a convenient button to immediately switch to the network to which you send our tokens. And let's move from the Ethereum network to the Avalanche network as the next final step. I choose a stablecoin I want to send. Our USDT has not yet reached us on Ethereum, so I only have 12 here. I press the maximum and see what happens. A message immediately pops up that we can send at least $30 through the bridge. That is, we cannot transfer the amount below 30 through bridge MetaMask. Accordingly, now I need to wait until my $30 arrive on the Ethereum network. The transaction has already been completed, but there is no display yet. So I set up the Ethereum Avalanche network again and then select the USDT that have already flown. I'll set 30 minimum. And we see the commission will take us almost $6. Let me set even 31. Okay, launch the transaction from Ethereum to Avalanche. For almost $5 in commission, we send our USDT. Also, let's send with Ethereum to Polygon. If you choose a stable coin, and for example, I will set 20 USDT. Let's see if it is possible to send them now, or there will also be a minimum of 30 USDT. We wait. Indicates that at least 30 USDT can be sent from Ethereum to Polygon, so now we can no longer make this transaction. Or we need to replenish our USDT again. And also with Ethereum you can more likely send it to Binance Smart Chain, but here you also need at least 30 USDT since the commission will take most of it. Now, together with you, we have made an exchange via bridge from Avalanche to Polygon, then from Polygon to Binance Smart Chain, after which Binance Smart Chain to Ethereum. From Ethereum you can further send it to several networks, also to Polygon, to Binance Smart Chain and to Avalanche. Well, besides this, I will recommend you to make swaps inside the MetaMask wallet. I think you have already heard that this will also increase the likelihood of a retrodrop. Since when you use a swap inside MetaMask without accessing DEX, for example Uniswap or PancakeSwap, and so on, depending on the network you need, you pay a commission directly to the founder of MetaMask. That is the MetaMask project, and the commission inside MetaMask is always more than when using the same one each wallet. Therefore, it is beneficial for MetaMask to make the exchange inside the wallet. Well, let's try do it now. In order to make an exchange within MetaMask, we need to click on the swap button below our balance. And then we can choose what we want to change to. For example, I have Ethereum and let's exchange Ethereum for USDT stablecoin. Specify the amount that we want to change. For example, 0.5. Let's set even 0.02 and click Review Swap. And then click Preparing Swap. Please note, then this indicates the commission that we will pay in the amount of $3.25. And below is also the MetaMask fee 0.743%. It means that MetaMask take less than 1% for the commission. Next, swap is starting and we can see an approximate time of 2 minutes 30 seconds. But it was completed much faster and you can see a message swap complete. Click the close button. And let's move on to Binance Smart Chain and also do the exchange of crypto assets. Let's choose, for example, BNB we want to exchange for BUSD. Set 0.1, click review swap, wait a bit, and then click swap. The exchange process starts and the transaction on Binance Smart Chain was completed much faster than on Ethereum. Now we press swap and let's exchange back BUSD for BNB, for example the same amount of 35. I press swap and our transaction went fairly quickly. And finally, let's exchange it for Polygon networks, for example Matic for USDT. Let's get one Matic, there for 0.78. Click swap and see if the exchange works inside Polygon. We are waiting for some time. All transactions are completed. Quite quickly we exchanged one Matic for 0.77 USDT. I also advise you to do swaps on all networks in the order to increase the change of an airdrop. You can exchange any crypto assets in one direction or the other. The main thing is that you do this on all networks on MetaMask. Well, keep in mind that you need to have coins for the commission in each network, because on Polygon you will pay the commission in MATIC, on Binance Smart Chain BNB, on Ethereum of course in ETH. Set a big fat like for this video because it really increases the chance of this Retrodrop. Therefore, do not be shy, like, subscribe and be sure to write comments whether you managed to do all the steps or on some of the actions you had a snag or still have questions. If something does not work out, write in the comments, I will try to help you. And be sure to write whether it is worth making such videos that do not guarantee profit, but nevertheless increase the chance of getting tokens for free. If yes, be sure to write in comments so that I understand in which direction to move and what content will be useful to you.
Thanks for your time and see you soon.